shame. And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true. Its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. And I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange someday for a crown. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a
reading from the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the right path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Cloveilla Montgomery Parker passed away on Sunday, July 24, 2016, at the age of 101. She was born February 16, 1915, to John Alexander and Emma Ernelius Lack Montgomery on the Bish Ranch near Brock, Texas. Cloveilla had four older brothers, Isaac Raymond, Orrin Bunch, nicknamed Wendy, Lauren Thompson, nicknamed George, William Odell, and six younger brothers, John Haskell, Prosper Wilson, nicknamed Smokey, Ovid Hoyle, Hasper Lee, nicknamed Johnny, Everett Pride, and J.E. Her sister-in-law, Eula V. Smithers Montgomery, who was married to John Haskell, was like a sister and very close to Cloveilla. Cloveilla graduated from Brock High School on May 18, 1934. In 1939, she moved to California, where she worked at various jobs until Lockheed hired her in August of 1942. She worked on the P-38 Lightning Fighters. After World War II ended, Cloveilla was one of the few women rehired by Lockheed. Cloveilla remained at Lockheed until she married John Thomas Jack Parker on April 3, 1947 in Pasadena, California. Cloveilla and Jack moved to the Parker family farm in Cargill, Ontario, Canada. While in Canada, Cloveilla had two children, William Everett Parker and Linda Adele Parker. Cloveilla and Jack left the farm, bought a China gift shop and appliance store in Walkerton, Ontario. She managed the store until they moved to Porterville, California in 1952. Cloveilla and Jack owned a mobile home park in Porterville, a paint store in Pismo Beach, and in 1955 bought a motel, Casa del Sol, in Carpinteria, California. They sold the motel in 1964 and moved to Myra Street in Carpinteria. In 1971, they built a lovely home in Santa Barbara, California. Cloveilla lived in this home until almost 99 years old. She grew many avocado and fruit trees and filled her yard with roses, hibiscus, and many other plants. Cloveilla was a talented gardener, cook, quilter, painter, and tailor. She could design and sew a dress without a pattern. She did needlepoint, embroidery, crocheting, knitting, sewing, rug making, and many other crafts. Survivors include son, William Parker, daughter, Linda Parker Spaulding, and husband, Alan, grandchildren, Jonathan Parker and wife, Nancy, Kimberly Parker, William Spaulding and wife, Sarah, and Thomas Spaulding, great-grandsons, Peter Parker Spaulding, Logan Eugene Spaulding, and Nathan Parker. Great-granddaughter, Lana Rose Parker. Special friends, Helen Jim, Catherine Price, and Betty Crane, and many nieces, nephews, other family members, and friends. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we come before you at this time. As we gather in this place, remember this one who has passed on into eternity. And we just pray that you will comfort this family upon this day. Help us through this day, Lord. In Jesus' name we ask. Amen. We gather here today to honor, to remember, and to say goodbye to Cloveilla. Cloveilla was one that loved her country. She loved her country very much. She was active as a Republican. And even though she lived in other places outside of Texas, places in this country and places outside of this country, she was still a Texas girl at heart. She always loved her roots that led her back to Texas. Now, the obituary covered a lot of her life, but in addition to the things that were covered, I'd like to point out a few things. She worked on the P-38 Light and Fire. She was one that was given to detail in whatever she did. And because of her size, she had an advantage. She was able to get into the tight places because on the cockpits that she worked in on those fighters, her job was to solder the wiring. And it was easier for her to get into such tight places and to do her job very well. She loved to garden. And maybe some of you think in your memories of the things that she had raised and the fruits of her labors. She loved roses. How fitting this morning upon the casket we see a spray of roses, because that fit her life and the things that she enjoyed. She loved gardening so much that until age 98, when she no longer could do so, she would use her walker, and she would give everything she had to go out with her walker into the garden and work in her garden, because she loved her garden and she loved to be outdoors and work in that environment. She loved to be involved in crafts, and she was very talented with her hands. She was able to use her hands to create things and build things, anything that had to do with crafts. And she, above that, she could take things and use her hands and make things better. Whatever it was, she could work with her hands and use that blessing and fix things and better make things better in life. She was a woman that early in her life, she became the woman of the family very early. As was stated in the obituary, she had many brothers, and during the pregnancies of her mother, she had to take part in stepping up and being the woman for her brothers to take care of them and to help them with whatever they needed. You know, Ecclesiastes, the 8th chapter, the 8th verse reads, "There is no man that hath power over the spirit to retain the spirit, neither hath he power in the day of death." Now, we can do nothing upon our own except for God gives the increase, and God gives the blessing. Psalms 90 and 10 reads, "The days of our years are 80 years, that's 70 years old. But if by reason of strength they be 80 years, that's 80. Yet there is strength, labor, and sorrow, for it is soon cut off, and we fly away." We're talking about a loved one here who lived well beyond the average lifespan. Well beyond. God blessed her to live well beyond the average lifespan. And can you imagine for a moment all the things, the changes that she saw in her life? The things in the area of medicine, of transportation, of this life in general, of media, of society. And we're talking about an individual that lived during the Great Depression. And while her family had no money, or much money, they never did without food. Here was an individual that knew what it was like to have to go out to the cistern and draw water for the cooking, for the cleaning, and for the baths. One by one, to go out and gather buckets of water and bring them into the house. Something that many people today only read about in history books. Here our loved one experienced that and saw the changes of life and the way this world changed. And here was one who knew what it was like to join the family once a month as they would hitch up the buggy, the buckboard, and head to town to buy the supplies they needed. All for the changes that this our loved one saw during her time of life. You know, the family has put in the back foyer there on the registry stand some sheets, and they've asked for me to announce that if any of you have memories of Cloveilla, of times you spent with her and things she meant to you, that you would take the time to take one of those sheets and write down that memory. And there's an address on the sheet that you can send to so that the family can have all of those sheets and compile them together. But I want to take an opportunity at this moment to ask any of you, if there's anyone who would like to stand up and share a memory that you have with Cloveilla, that you're free to do so at this moment. Feel free to write your memories down on those sheets. Cloveilla was a member of the Church of Christ. She had an understanding of the things that are religious in nature. No doubt she had an understanding of what awaits each one of us beyond the grave. You know, Ecclesiastes 7:1 reads, "A good name is better than precious ointment, and the day of death than the day of one's birth. It is better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of feasting, for this is the end of all men, and the living will lay it to its heart." Now, why would it be better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of feasting? Genesis 3rd chapter tells about the fall of man, and because of sin, man could not live forever on this earth. And because of sin, man was lost without hope. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, and whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but hath everlasting life." 1 Corinthians 15:50 reads, "Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of heaven, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption." You see, the Bible tells us that this fleshly body that we have today, that we're housed in, that we live in today, it cannot go beyond this life. At some point in time, we all have to lay aside this fleshly body to go into the spiritual world. And to go in the spiritual world is necessary to bring us into the presence of God. The writer of Hebrews, there in the 9th chapter, the 27th verse, brings this thought very clear to us. And so, our loved one has done just that, has left the fleshly body and has gone into the spiritual world. And we can be assured this day that Cloveilla is not dead. She's very much alive and lives in eternity. Yes, she's dead in the sense of unconsciousness. We no longer can talk to her, or tell her we love her, share stories with her. But we know that she's alive in eternity. Jesus explained in Mark 12:27 that God is not the God of the dead, but God of the living. And so we can have that peace today. Philippians 4:7, "And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." And so we can take that comfort in our heart today, knowing that even as God has a plan for each one of us, he had a plan for Cloveilla. And our loved one, even though she no longer lives in this life, and even though she's passed on into eternity, I want to tell you this morning, she still lives in this carnal realm. And how can that be? How can she still live in this carnal realm? You see, she lives in our memory. She lives in the memories that we have of her, the memories that no one can take away, the memories that are in our hearts that are priceless, that we will always have to be able to cherish and to remember her and of the times that we spent with her and the times we talked with her, what she meant to us and the things that she did. You know, knowing the Lord like she did, in 1933, she obtained her first Bible. And that Bible is with her today in the casket. And that Bible will accompany her beyond this world and into the final resting place where we will go in a short while. And so, even though she's passed on in the hands of a loving and a kind and merciful Heavenly Father, Revelation, the 20th chapter, verses 11 through 15, tell us that this is so. And even though Cloveilla no longer lives in this carnal realm, she shall live on in our memory as a mother, as a grandmother, as a great-grandmother, as a sister, as a loved one, as a friend. 2 Timothy, the 4th chapter, the 6th verse, the Apostle Paul writes, "For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing." Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you for the time that you allowed Cloveilla to be upon this earth. We thank you for the love that we had towards her and she had towards all of her family, loved ones, and friends. And we pray, Heavenly Father, that you will help us through this time, the family, loved ones, and friends, that they might be comforted. And we pray, Heavenly Father, that those memories, that we will always cherish them, and of all those happy times and what she meant to all of us and all the lives that she touched. And we just thank you for being so good to all of us, Heavenly Father. And we ask again that you would comfort this family and the loved ones and friends of this one who has passed on at this time. Forgive us of our sins. We pray through Jesus' name. Amen.